I know you're here with somebody, but I'm going home with that body. Yeah, so tell her she can move. And today we're going to be playing with Gallium! And right now I'm running a MacBook Air giveaway, and to enter it is so simple. Just join the firm and also subscribe to my second channel, Reacticorns, which is linked down below as well. If you haven't heard of Gallium before, this is a metal that literally melts in your hand. So crazy, right? I've never played with this before. It's my first time. Let's see if it melts. You ready? 3, 2, 1. Huh? Still solid.
Whoa! A little blob.
Couldn't play with Gallium a long time ago, but I waited for this special occasion because guess what, guys? We got... yes! Gallium wengiecorns!
Oh, look, it's so dirty already. I got smudge marks everywhere, but you can see my name.
I want to thank you guys so much because I couldn't have done this without you guys. You guys are the best fam in the whole entire YouTube. You guys are happy, inspired, creative.
I just want to say this from the bottom of my heart. I love you guys so much. Like literally, you guys are the reason I get out of bed every day and that I could stay happy and motivated. Like literally, you guys mean the world to me. Like I mean that 100%. And I never, like I try and say it as often as I can. But yeah, guys, I love you guys so much.
And to commemorate this special occasion, we're gonna be turning this diamond play button into gallium. Make sure you stay to the end, it's gonna be awesome. And without further ado, let's get to melting some gallium. Let's go. So this actually does melt in your hand, but it takes a little bit too long to do it, and I've got a lot of gallium to melt. So I have a better idea. Just kidding, guys. Safety first. I have a lot of gallium to melt. Like, check this out. I bought out the store and they're literally sold out right now. So apparently the best way to melt gallium is to actually put it in some hot water. And now it's time to melt some gallium.
Ooh. I can only fit 3. The bowl's so small.
Guys, is this gonna explode? So we can only fit 3 in this bowl, so let's get another one. All right, time to fit more. Look at that, the sides have like completely melted. Can you see that, guys? Look at this color, guys. For some reason, this one has like this blue tinge on it. Looks so magical. Okay, this bowl's not flat. Man's not hot. I'm hot though. So much steam. Guys, this is so crazy. I never thought I'd be melting metal. Liquid metal. Okay guys, remember I originally dropped this one in the water? I'm gonna try and get rid of some of that water now. Coordination. Oh no, what do I do? There's gallium in the bottom of the bowl. How do I get it out? Whoa. Smiley face. Is that a face? Whoa, it feels like nothing. I can't even feel the metal. Ooh, it doesn't stick to your fingers. Whoa, whoa. Oh, that is so cool. It's actually really heavy as soon as it comes out of the water. This feels so cool. Oh my gosh, check this out. Look, it's a heart. How cool is that? Stuck on my hands. Washes up. Get it in water, don't worry. Apparently you can syringe it out.
Whoa.
Ooh.
That's crazy.
Guys, we're gonna make a gallium fountain. Whoa! So we finally melted all the gallium, and now it's time to pour it into this. So our first experiment is gallium versus Coke can. Apparently, gallium is closely related to aluminium, so if you mix them together, the gallium actually destroys the aluminium. So what you want to do first is to actually use a sharp needle and kind of scratch the surface of the aluminium. And the next thing you want to do is get a small amount of gallium into your syringe and just drop it straight onto the scratches of your Coke can. And now all we have to do is wait for 1 hour and we can completely destroy this Coke can. Okay guys, this is now ready. Originally, I said it'd take only an hour, but I've left this sitting here for like 2 days. So like, it better work. It's still not solid. I don't know if this is a good thing or a bad thing. Woo! So if this thing has done its job, the Coke can should now be super weak and I should just be able to break it with my thumb. And speaking of thumbs, you guys need to give me some moral support to make sure this experiment works. Take 3 seconds, go find the like button down below and click it. 3, 2, 1. Have you guys done it? Also, don't forget to turn on the bell for notifications. With your help, this experiment should work. 3, 2, 1. No. Ah! Wengie 0, can 1, not happening. Have you guys clicked the like button? Maybe I need more thumbs up. Ah! Have a backup can I prepared. Let's see if this works. Ah! It's not a good day for me.
The internet always lies to me. They said it would work.
Nope. I give up. Okay guys, third time is a charm. Let's hope this works. Oh my gosh. Ah. Oh my gosh, can you see that? Can you see? It's just ripping. Whoa. Even that's soft. What is going on? Was there even gallium on this side? Did it go inside and infect the whole of the aluminium? That is insane, guys. Feels like wrapping paper. Like gold foil? Ah, look. How cool is this, guys? It finally worked, and I'm pretty sure it's all because of your life. Next up, we have some molds. So we're gonna make some gallium figurines today. They're gonna be so cute. We have a minion, we have a Lego man, and of course, we have a unicorn. So I know this is not a real unicorn, but I ordered a unicorn and they sent me this. So I'm just gonna call it a unicorn and go with it. Woo! This is a really heavy syringe. Oh my God, is it? It's literally syringing itself. Let's fill up the minion. Woo! Whoa! As you can see, guys, it's totally clumping together and it's really hard to get it into these little parts. It's probably because this gallium has a very high surface tension, which makes it hard for it to like spread out evenly. This is a very fat minion. Woo! It's like jello! Time for Lego Man. Woo! Gallium fountain! This one's much easier. Okay guys, I have a really good feeling about this Lego man. Let's move on to the unicorn. It's so detailed, I'm hoping this will turn out. Oh, look. Go, ooh. Is it gonna go into those little like wing spikes? This is hard. I don't know if this one will turn out. Oh my God, how fat is this unicorn? Okay, I think it's a bit too fat. Let's just, whoa. I think I put a bit too much gallium. Tiny legs. Come on. Okay guys, these molds are ready. Let's put them in the fridge to set. And now we're done. That was quick. Whoa guys, check these out. They're rock solid. solid. Actually, pretty heavy as well. Wow, this Lego man needs to go on a diet. So the first one I'm gonna take out is Mr. Lego Man. Oh, whoa! This is the coolest thing I've ever seen. Oh, I can't believe I'm making. He looks perfect. Look how sharp his little legs are. His cute little hands. It looks like a store-bought figurine. This is one of the best DIYs I've ever done. So out of the three molds, this looks the easiest. So let's move on to the next one. Minion time. Ah! Whoa! Look at how detailed the lines are. Look, like his eyes and his like goggles. It's so cute. Okay guys, I don't want to hold him too long in case I melt him. This actually looks kind of edible at the same time. Like this could be made of chocolate. I'd be like, ow.
Whoa, whoa. Guys, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. It actually turned out so well. Detail of the wings and everything.
It's a pretty unicorn.
Ah! Oh my gosh, guys, look at my creations. They all turned out so good.
But now it's time to destroy them. Which one should I destroy first?
Hi, Minion.
We're gonna destroy Mr. Minion with some boiling water.
Goodbye, Minion. You are so cute. Oh my gosh, he's melting. Whoa. That's crazy. He's melting. Melting.
It's time to destroy the unicorn Pegasus. Okay guys, that was getting really hot. Like my fingers were burning as well. Check out my fingers though. They're all black from the gallium. The next one's gonna be super dangerous. So definitely don't try this at home. Guys, I don't think I'm ready for this. Whoa, this is awesome.
Dang.
Goodbye, Lego Man. He's got no head. Gallium pancake. Yep, I have a problem. Now it's time to make our mold for our diamond play button. So the first thing we're gonna do is pop the play button face up into our mold container. Whoa! Why is this so satisfying? Okay guys, the mold is ready. It'll take 24 hours to set, but lucky for you guys, you don't have to wait. Oh look guys, it's done! The mold is done! And it was so easy. It's so heavy, how do I turn it over?
Oh, this is tough, guys.
Oh, it's not coming up.
Oh my gosh, guys, we are literally blowtorching the metal off because we can't get it out.
Yes, thank you.
I'm tapping in the man.
By getting through. Oh, yes!
This is a monster.
Okay, guys, it's time to take it out of the mold. And our mold is done. It finally came off. It was worth it, though. It's been a long, long journey, but now it's finally time to fill the button. Whoa. Oh my god, guys, check that out. Guys, can you see the holographic shards on the surface? Well guys, it's so reflective. It's like a mirror. You can see everything, even that face. And all we have to do now is wait for it to set. Whoa! Oh my gosh, guys, look, it's set. That was so quick. Look at the surface. This is crazy. Like, what is this? For some reason, there's these weird like corners, like literally looks like giant icicle. Oh my gosh, I see some air bubbles. This is so nerve-wracking. I hope this turns out. Like, this is literally taking us 5 days. Oh my gosh. Oh. It's like a play button with a disease. This play button looks so good. Apart from the disease, so it's not as thick as the original play button, but that's probably a good thing because even this thickness was a bit too heavy for me. Oh my gosh, guys, this is actually heavier than the real play button, and I thought the real play button was heavy. And now it's time for the celebration. Happy 10 million wengiecorns! Here's a huge hug to my fam. But the button has been destroyed. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed this DIY to celebrate my 10 million family members. I literally can't tell you how grateful I am to have you guys all in my life. And let's have a look at what happened on Reacticorns this week.
Hey, how are things with you? Good, who is this?
Did you reply to yourself?
Yes, it's crap. I think I did.
Alright guys, doing a huge shout out to my notification squad of the week and my wengiecorn of the week. If you guys want to find out how to get a shout out, don't forget to check the description box below. And also follow me on social media to see what happens behind the scenes during the week. I'm gonna miss you guys so much. Until next week, I will see you guys soon.